We're completely like it, we're not trying to sit there and make this into a big thing, but when you're criticizing like this, you need to recognize you're the reason this happened.
And this is what happens when you
do an engine start without removing before flight.
So, with that being said, let's go back to the beginning and start this all over.
Call comes out down the street.
Now that we're burning.
I wait. Nobody says
okay.
Anything.
But it's
I'm picking my battles on it. But
but you take
a lead
on it.
Josh.
Yeah.
I got some good news and I got some bad news.
Is the bad news I'll have to spend money?
No, no. The good news is that the sound pack is installed and ready to go. The bad news is that you should never try and do an engine start when you've forgotten to do the remove before flight stuff, because the engine just catches on fire.
Sucked in his engine cowling covers and stuff. Just freaking those tie downs on the blades are like.
So, we've had to call for another helicopter, and we're going to try it again. Just wanted you to know. All right, well, let's go ahead and get this started here and try it again. Here we are at Vancouver International at one of my hubs here at Air America Douai. And today, as you see, we're going to be doing a FSEconomy flight. And one of the things, though, I wanted to bring up is this X-Trident Bell412 sound mod version 2.0. It was actually done and updated in 2016. Done by Joshler10. It's something we're going to try out today. It's something I heard about. The sound pack was made by taking actual recordings of the Bell 412 and adapting it to the X-Plane simulation. So we're going to give that a shot today and see how that goes. And as you can see, this is where you can get it if you're interested. And right now we're sitting at CYVR, which is Vancouver International, and we're going to be flying to Float Haven in Bellingham, Washington, the state of Washington in the United States. That is a float plane base and does not have any runway. So the only way we can get in there is by boat, float plane, or helicopter. So it's a 44-mile flight, and we're going to do that. And basically, this flight is going to, we're going to take these five passengers to the float plane base. We're going to pick up three passengers at the float plane base and bring them back to Vancouver International, where we will pick up three more passengers to take back to the float plane base. So this is my first flight to this location, so we'll just see how it goes. And with that, first things first, go down to the 412. Wait a minute. Take your time, William. Enable hardware throttles. Go down here. Remove before flight. Now, when we do an engine startup, we won't catch on fire. So, let's toggle client window. Let's log in. Let's see if we can start the flight. I haven't rented the aircraft. Well, in that case, let's go back up here. excuse me there. Let's go to Airport CYVR. Okay. Now we can go to my flight. Well, that's just not cricket. All right. So let's get some repairs done. We'll be right back. Okay, well, repairs have been completed. So let's get to our helicopter. Let's see about starting the flight. Flight is started, so all is good. All right, let's get inside. And go. And let's see here. And I already have this in the catalog. So let's see
what HTOS test okay.
Activate. Very good. And that'll work. All right. So we've got all that done. Let's go here.
HTOS test okay.
Okay. All right. So. Got the engine throttles cracked. Let's get our fuel going. Okay. And let's, controls are good. Yeah, I hear you. Okay. Pissed you off, though, didn't I? Alright. Let's see about starting up the engines. Seems pretty quiet outside. Three William, not 103. Okay. All All right, let's look at them. They look, check the engines here, see if they're synced up. And they are. Very good. Okay, turn your, the autopilot's okay. External power. All right, so, autopilot one, okay. And go up here, get rid of external power. Oh, that's right, different helicopter. This one, we get rid of external power by doing this. Get rid of the GPU. Okay, so we got that. All warning lights are off. Okay, I know what we need to do. All right, let's... Okay, that's all looking good. So let's take a look here. Sounding pretty good. Let's get a little more sound outside. Let's run up the engines. Good. Okay. Everything's looking good. Looks like we got a glitch in here that I'm not used to seeing.
Caution. Wire. Wire. Caution. Wire. Wire. Caution. Wire. Wire.
Me and Zombie seem to think that sound does sound better. Plane base. There's a glitch in here that wasn't there before, but it may have been just from this loading, so we'll see. 38 miles to go. Right about 108 knots. It's not going to take as long to get there. 2 miles. Start slowing down here.
Caution. Terrain. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. Terrain.
Yeah, there it is, right there.
Caution. Terrain. Terrain.
Caution.
Terrain. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. Terrain. Caution, terrain, terrain. Caution, terrain, terrain. Caution, terrain,
500.
Terrain. Four hundred. Five hundred. Four hundred. 300.
300.
200.
200.
100.
100.
50.
50.
Okay, so we go ahead and landed okay. Let's slow down the engine rotor. See. This is where my ordnance is.
Thank you.
Okay, so. Throttles are down. Okay, so we can finish this flight. And then we can start this flight. The engine started back up. Okay, so with that, $294. Alrighty, so see about getting into the air again. pretty good. Alright, let us be on our way.
Terrain. Warning. Terrain. Terrain. Warning. Terrain. Terrain. Warning. Terrain. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. Terrain.
Okay, we'll go ATT mode. That should put us on heading good. Head back to Vancouver International.
Four hundred. Two hundred. 100. 100. 100.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop it right here and reload the aircraft, see if I can get rid of that glitch that's taking place here on my control panel. So. Okay, so here we are back at Vancouver International. Flight completed. We're going to call it a day. There's still half of a flight left, but did this one. Got to say to my flight sim buddies that the sound mod seems to work fairly well. It does sound better than the out-of-the-box sounds, so I'll definitely be keeping it. And we'll experiment with it a little bit and see how things go. The sound mod basically just changed all the engine sounds, and we'll see how that goes. I'm going to try and do some research and see if I can figure out why I've got that sounds like the turbine spooling up off and on during the flight. That may be a conflict with the sound mod. So we'll see how that goes. But all in all, good flights. Helicopter worked well, so with that, another day we've completed things. Sure hope you enjoyed the flight, sure enjoyed having you along, and until next time, this is Bug Eater 64, and as always, Safe flying.